Her job at the Turnpike Authority Board has come to an end, and now Mary Connaughton is here, and she's looking for a new position. However, she's going to be looking for your help as a voter in this state to help her get this position. Mary's joining us this morning. She wants to talk to us about why she is running for state auditor. But great to see you.
Great to be here again.
Yeah, they're wondering if you got the 12-page Eloise goodbye.
No, I would love to read
it. I spent
it.
10 months, and I wrote more pages than the months that I spent there.
I certainly would like to read that.
You were a member of the Turnpike Board, and before we move any further, we have to talk about the fact that this weekend the Turnpike came to an end, and now it comes under this big umbrella agency. Your feelings about this?
Well, I have some concerns. I think, number one, there could be some great opportunities there to streamline transportation to function. But as far as the cost savings that were billed to the public, I have enormous concerns as to whether or not any of those are going to be realized. In order for there to be actual cost savings, there has to be a significant workforce reduction.
Right.
And from what I can see and what I read, they're planning on 300 people at some point, but there's no timeline for that.
Right. And you were talking about this new board and how much power it's going to have.
Right. It's an enormously powerful board. It's a 5-member board. All Governor Patrick appointees, and this board will have majority control over this new transportation entity, which includes all the highways, what was the Turnpike, DCR bridges, the Registry of Motor Vehicles, and the transit. They'll be able to raise fares, raise tolls, seize property, issue debt, raise registry fees, and they're not ultimately accountable to the electorate because they're all appointees.
Sure.
And if there is a new governor, next year, after 2010,
right,
that governor will have this board to deal with for the first 3 years of his or her term, and that's going to be quite a challenge.
That'll be very interesting, won't it?
It is going to be very interesting, and with the amount of money that's flowing through this, the hundreds of millions of dollars in contracts that they'll be able to award, it's enormous. The controls over this have to be tight. And let's see. Let's see if there's going to be savings, because mm-hmm. that was what this was built for.
Sure.
Reform for reform's sake means nothing, but we want to see the savings. We want to realize.
Right. Absolutely. Okay, now, having said all of that,
yes.
and the money, and the way it's all funded out, you sat on this Turnpike board for a long time, and you
yes.
watched this going on a first-hand basis. Is this part of what has drawn you to the idea of running for auditor?
Actually, yes. I mean, this 4 years, having an up front row seat of how government operates, how state government operates, and how closely one has to pay attention to the fine print
mm-hmm.
and what's going on. And with what's going on with the newspapers pulling back from the State House, the regional newspapers, we need good eyes on Beacon Hill. We need fresh eyes on Beacon Hill to see what's going on. I mean, I have seen so much. I've seen things that, I mean, I've uncovered mistakes, major errors and in terms of what was being brought forward to the public. I've done my best to achieve transparency at this board. I'm very concerned that this new MassDOT board won't have the same level of transparency. And I think the people of the Commonwealth want to see someone that's really going to keep an eye out for them and clue them in on what's going on, and that is what I see as the major role of this job.
Well, one of the things that you just said is that Beacon Hill needs fresh eyes. You're running against a 6-term
yes.
auditor, Joe DiNucci, of course a Democrat. That's a tough undertaking because he's got that statewide name.
Well, it is going to be a huge challenge, but, you know, it's a challenge I'm up for. I've challenged them on the Turnpike Board. I grew up with four brothers. Growing up with four brothers, you learn to take on challenges early in life, and that's what I intend
that's
to do.
For sure you do. And also for people maybe who don't know, you're an accountant.
Yes, I started my career after graduating from UMass Amherst at Ernst & Young in Boston. So I started out as an auditor. I still am a CPA. I think having an auditor be the state auditor probably makes good sense, and I'm hoping that the people agree with that.
Well, listen, we'll be following you. We wish
Thank
you the best of luck.
Thank
We're
you
so
very
glad
much.
You've come in to see us this morning.